Hello students, welcome to today's English class. I am Rupna Ravindran, Assistant Professor of English, Government Degree College, Jewella, in Rangaredi District of Telangana State. Today we are going to discuss the topic prefixes and suffixes. This is part of your English textbook, English Made Easy, prescribed by Osmania University for first year, first sem, BA, BCom and BSc students. Let us go to the next slide. What is a prefix and what is a suffix? Let us find out from the definition. Actually, building your vocabulary is very important to speak in English. Prefixes and affixes are topic that comes in the vocabulary section. So, adding affixes to root words is an easy and interesting way to develop a vocabulary. Root word is the word to which we have to add affixes. Affixes can be prefix or suffix. So many new words are formed by adding an affix to the beginning or end of the root word, and the meaning changes accordingly. So, root word is a word in its simplest form, and to the root word we add prefixes in the beginning and suffixes in the end of the word. Let us look at some examples so that it becomes clear for you. Root words are also called base words. For example, right, happy, back, heat, etc. If you add an affix to the root or base word, will change the meaning. For example, let us take the word happy. Happy is the base word, or happy can be called a root word. So we are going to add a prefix or an affix, okay, to the word happy. Let us add the prefix un, that is un, to the base word happy. Then we know that the meaning completely changes. The meaning becomes the antonym of the word happy, opposite to the word happy, unhappy. Okay, and then we can add a suffix also to the word base word or the root word happy. What is the suffix that we can add to the root word happy? I-L-Y. We can add I-L-Y to the word happy, happily. Okay, so we are adding a suffix I-L-Y to the root word happy, and again the meaning changes. They lived happily. Okay, so it becomes an adverb there. Now, prefixes and affixes are both prefixes and suffixes are both called affixes. Prefixes are word parts that come at the beginning of the root word. Here I have given the definition in this slide. A prefix is a group of letters or an affix that is added at the beginning of the word. Now, when these two or three letters come at the beginning of the word, it is called a prefix. And suffix is an affix that is added at the end of the word. When these two, three letters come at the end of the word, then it is the suffix. So, the example that we have already discussed is unhappy. Un is prefix. In the word happily, I-L-Y is the suffix. I hope I am clear. Now, prefixes modify the meaning of the word. They can make a word negative, they can show repetition or indicate opinion. So, in the example that we have taken, unhappy, un gives a negative meaning. It gives an opposite meaning to the base word. We have taken the base word happy, we have added un along with it, and we got a negative meaning. We got a opposite meaning, or an opposite meaning. Third point here, some suffixes add to or change a word's meaning. Others signal words, parts of speech, or indicate verb tense. So some suffixes can change that meaning completely, while other suffixes can change the parts of speech. For example, we have seen happy changed to happily, an adverb. It can indicate a verb tense form also. For example, play, playing. We are adding a suffix ing along with the base word or root word play. So we are changing the tense form. Play will come in a simple present tense. When we are adding ing form to play, it becomes continuous tense, playing. Let us look at another example. We have some common prefixes. Some of the most common prefixes in English language are dis, in, un, which make words negative. For instance, adding the prefix un to the word kind creates the word unkind. So here is the example I was talking about. Earlier we added un to the word happy. Here we are adding un to the word kind. So the word becomes unkind and meaning is not kind. So we got an opposite meaning. So what are the some of the common prefixes that we use? Most common prefixes that we use are dis, in, and un. These three things. So I'll give you another example. Look at the word uncooked. UNCOOKED, uncooked. So in this word, un is the prefix, cook is the root or the base word, and ed is the suffix. So let me repeat. We are taking the word uncooked. In this word, un is the prefix, cook is the root word, and ed is the suffix. Now let us look at more examples to understand the words, root words, prefixes, and suffixes. And now you take a letter A. By adding a prefix to the word, its meaning changes. For example, you take the example moral. The word moral, MORAL. You are adding a letter A to that, amoral, and the meaning changes. Political, apolitical. Social, asocial. Then let us look at another example. We are taking two letters, AB, as prefix, which means away from. Ab means away from. So let us take these examples, abnormal, AB. NORMAL, abnormal. So we are adding the prefix AB to the word normal. We can take another example, abduction. In that word, ABDUCTION, abduction. To kidnap. Abduction means to kidnap. So in that word, AB is a prefix. Okay, so coming to the slide, another common prefix is re, which indicates repetition. For example, adding re to the word build means to build again. Okay, so we have the root word build and we are adding re to the root word build, so it becomes to build again, so it shows repetition. Other prefixes can indicate position. Sub meaning under or below. Sub registrar. So under the registrar. As found in common words like subway, submarine, etc. Supra. Supra, which means above. And it often appears in medical terminology. Supraclavicular nerve. Supra. Clavicular nerves, which lies on top of the veins and bones. It is a medical term. We are not much aware of that term. Let us move on to the next slide. Yeah, there are certain rules for adding prefixes. When you add a prefix to a word, you shouldn't change the spelling of the original word or the prefix. The word disappear is a combination of the prefix dis and appear. Unhappy. Okay. Un is a prefix and happy is a root word. Undo. Un is a prefix and do is the base word. All illustrate this guideline. For this rule, even if the spelling results in double consonants, such as in the word misspell, so it's not a problem. How do you spell the word misspell? MISPEL. Okay, and you have certain words like cooperation, irredeemable, etc. You should have a hyphen when joining a prefix to a proper noun. For example, pro-American. American is a proper noun. So, when you are adding a prefix to the proper noun, you have to add a hyphen in between. Pro-American. So, that is another example. Hyphen can also prevent misreading, mispronunciation or confusion with other words. You should hyphenate certain words like recover, re hyphen cover, to avoid confusing with recover. Recover means to regain strength, recovered from some illness, we say that. Okay, so there is difference between those two words. Let us move on to suffixes. In a similar way, we add certain words at the end of the root words. Okay, and we change the meaning of the word. Here in this slide, I have given certain additions, that is, some common suffixes are ed, ing and ly. The suffix ed changes verbs to the past tense. You might have learned v1, v2, v3 of regular verbs. So, when we are changing the present form to simple past tense form for the regular verbs, we add ed form. For example, Sandy shoveled the snow. Ed suffix creates the past tense of the verb to shovel. The ing suffix makes the verb take place in the present continuous tense. Sandy is shoveling in the snow. So, tenses are changing here, and the suffix ly is commonly added to adjectives. Happily, we have already discussed. Okay. Examples of adverbs with ly are joyfully, quickly, loudly, etc. The suffix s and es make words plural. For example, foxes, lambs, chairs, etc. All these we know, but then we didn't take notice of suffixes there. Okay, here we are particularly taking into regard the word suffix. Now let us look at another example. When we add c-i-d-e as a suffix to the root word, it means killing. For a C-I-D-E, when we add this suffix to a word, it becomes killing. Examples are suicide, pesticide, infanticide, patricide, etc. By just adding side at the end of the base word, we are giving new meanings to the words. Suicide, killing your killing or taking your own life. Okay. A pesticide, to kill the pest in the field, etc. Now, there are certain rules for adding suffixes. When you add a suffix to the word, the original word usually keeps its original spelling. However, there are some exceptions in this rule. If the original word is one syllable and ends in a single consonant, then double the last letter. For example, tip becomes tipping. You are adding a letter. It's one syllable. Run, running. If the word ends in multiple consonants, as in the word bank, last letter doesn't get doubled. Here you have exercise. Now we have to add prefixes to the given words. You are given 20 words, and for this 20 words you have to add prefixes. For example, you are given the prefixes anti, de, dis, im, mis, over, non, pre, re, un, in. So if you are given a word like regularly, then which prefix will you add? Irregularly. If you are given a word like comfortable, then which prefix will you add? Uncomfortable, If you are given a base word organized, then you have to add a prefix dis along with that, disorganized. Now let us look at the exercises given here, and we have to choose the prefixes from the choices given here, only from the choices given here. First one is behave. So what will be the prefix? It is misbehave. Next one is sense. Look at the prefixes given there and then try which prefix will suit the word, the base word sense. It is nonsense. How about the third one? Dash possible. Opposite of possible is impossible. Fourth one, dash happy. We have already discussed it. Unhappy. Fifth one, dash fiction. For essays and all, what do we say? Non-fiction. For proses and all, we say non-fiction, which is not a story. Fiction is story, novel and all. Dash place. If you place something at a wrong place, then what do you call that? Misplace. Then dash prove. See which of the prefixes suit there. Improve, I am improve. Next is mischief, mischief, mischief. Dash healthy, unhealthy. Dash move. We need to add a prefix along with move to have a meaning, different meaning. Or it can be a repetition also. For repetition, we use the word remove. You take it away. Next is place. We have already written place, but there is another option also. Displace is also another option. So, dis is a prefix. Dash code. Which one will be the correct prefix to add along with the word code? Decode. Next one is dash went, invent. Next one, 14th one, dash social. Which prefix will you add? Anti-social, anti-ragging, okay? Against, anti means against. Next, 15th one, dash obey. Opposite of obey, disobey. 16th one, dash act. Overact. 16th one is overact. 17th one, dash septic. Yes, it is easy, antiseptic. 18, dash age, image. 19th, dash pend, P-E-N-D, depend. 20th, dash serve, preserve. P-R-E-S-E-R-V-E, preserve. So let us move on to the next slide where we are given a word. In this word, we have a root word as well as a suffix. We need to identify the correct suffix in the given words. For example, you have the word autograph given there. And in this word, you have to find out the suffix. What is the suffix in this center, in this word autograph? Graph is the suffix. Loving, ing is the suffix. Noisy, y is the suffix. Pumping, again ing is the suffix there. Candies, ies. Likeable, able is the suffix. Confusing, ing is the suffix. Description, T-I-O-N, suffix. Relaxation, same as description. What is the suffix there? T-I-O-N is the suffix. Spelled. It is the past tense form of the verb spell. How do you make the past tense form of the word spell? You add ed along with it. You add the suffix ed. So here the suffix is ed. Similar case with the word preferred. Again, ed form. Prefer, and the V2 form or the past tense form of the verb is preferred. Next one is commitment. In this, the suffix is ment. Confusion, we are adding ion. Explosion, education, discussion, admission, all are similar. Copying, ing is the suffix. Imaginary, ary is the suffix. You are given options in this. You have to select the correct prefix or suffix, whatever is given there. First one is merit, and you are given four options: REDIDEDIS. So which one will be the correct answer? Yes, option C, that is demerit. You have to write the correct answer as demerit. And second one, post. And for post, we are given four options: B, out, age, on. In this, some are prefixes and some are suffixes. So you need to add the correct one in the correct place. Which one will be the correct one? AGE, postage, is correct. So that has meaning. Postage is actually the money that you pay for sending letters. Next one is date, DATE. So you are given certain prefixes here. Which one will be the correct? Undate is the correct word. Undate means to remove the date from a place. Okay. Fourth one, this is very easy. Spoken. In, D, out, dis. Correct answer is outspoken. Outspoken means being very frank in stating one's opinion, especially if they are very much controversial or shocking for other people. Fifth one, advantage. Opposite of advantage is disadvantage. Minister, you need to add any of the four options given here. They are by, over, on, ex. Yeah, the answer is option D, that is ex-minister. Seventh one, relevant. What is the opposite of the word relevant? Irrelevant. 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 Eighth one, large. You are repeating the word large. You are making it even larger. So which one? Enlarge. Ninth one, circle. You are given four options: an, sem, semi, en. Semicircle. Looker. You are given four options again: on, out, d, in. The answer is onlooker. Here you are given sentences, and in the sentences you need to add the correct prefix or suffix. So a prefix or suffix are very important topic for you, not only from your syllabus or your semester examination point of view, but when you go ahead in life and write competitive examinations. For all Indian competitive examinations, you will have definitely questions from prefixes and suffixes. So it is important for you to learn numerous prefixes and suffixes. So you have to learn the technique. You have to find out a technique and then learn as much as prefixes and suffixes as possible. And if you are not clear about the meaning, you have to refer the dictionary, learn the meaning so that it stays there in your mind. So these are some of the examples taken from certain competitive examinations. Let us look at the first example. Prabha is thinking to go back to university and take a dash course, dash graduation course. So the options given are pre, post, under, and super. So which one will be correct? Post can be correct, under can be correct, but only one will suit here. Which one? Yes, it is definitely, the answer is definitely post graduation course, because you are given the article A before that. Okay, so if you are writing undergraduation course, you need to have the article an there. So here you are going to write a post-graduation course, and in university most often you will have post-graduation courses only. Second example, you should not eat this pasta as it is dash cook, overcook, undercook, miscook, anti-cook. Which one will be the example? It is bad because it is not cooked. Even if it is overcooked, it is okay, we can manage. But if it is not cooked, if it is less cooked, so we cannot eat. So the answer here, the prefix here is undercook. Third one, there occurred a dash agreement in the contract. You are given the options dis, miss, un, and less. So the answer is disagreement. Opposite of agreement is disagreement. There had been a conflict and they couldn't agree. So there had been a disagreement in the contract. Fourth example, Ram expressed his disappointment. Oh, I've already given the answer. Ram expressed his disappointment towards the performance of his employee. So meant is the suffix there. Next one, in India it is dash legal to keep lion in the house. Unknown, illegal is the correct answer. We have to write illegal, IL. Saloni sued her dash husband for $2 million. Ex-husband, that is the correct prefix that you have to use there, ex. Seventh one, the mental condition of the patient is dash stable. To mention not stable, which prefix will be used normally? We use the prefix un, unstable. The mental condition of the patient is unstable. Anil lost the competition due to his dash. They are given variety of spellings. You need to choose the correct spelling. Laziness, the fourth option is the correct one. Ninth one, Amita was dash the sweater, knitting. First option is correct. K-N-I-T-T-I-N-G, knit. So for one syllable, we are adding the repetition of the last letter. We are doubling it. Tenth one, what is the prefix used in the word exam? Exam is just a word. You don't have any prefix or suffix added to that in the given example. Okay, so answer is none of the above. Now let me move on to a more extensive list of prefixes, suffixes and root word, so that it can help you prepare for different competitive examinations. So I hope you are very clear about prefixes, suffixes and root words. Now we are going to discuss Greek and Latin root words. English language has its root in several languages, so including Greek, Latin and other older forms of English, German and French also. So we have to learn to recognize the common roots and affixes. So this will help you build your vocabulary and also to make educative guesses about unknown words as well in certain test-taking situations. So good dictionaries will also give you information about the origin of words. So whenever you look up for a new word, make a point to read this information, that is about the origin of the word. Some of the roots and affixes that appear in large number of words. So learning these kinds of roots and affixes, that is affixes means prefix or suffix, will help you enhance your vocabulary and also to learn new terminology. So an example of a Latin word would be cent, C-E-N-T. Means 100. So we can form two words by adding the root word cent, that is cent. A century, in this cent becomes a prefix. Century, meaning 100 years. And another one is a Greek root word, that is graph. We can add it as a prefix in the word graphology, and we can also add it as a suffix in the word autograph. Okay. Now, let us look at this table that is given here. First one is a or an. So, meaning of that is without, not. So, examples given here are asexual, amoral, anarchy, anhydrous, anabaptist, and anachronism. Okay. Next one is AB, ABS, and I, which means apart or away from. For example, abnormal, abduct, kidnapped, etc. Next prefix is AD, which means towards, adhere, stick to. Adhere means stick to. We'll move on to this one, amphi. You might have heard amphi is round. You might have seen the amphitheater. Amphibian, an animal which can live both in land and water. Both. Next, anthro, which means man. Anthropology, anthropomorphic. So you can write down all these things. Anti means against, opposite, anticlimax, antipathy, etc. Aqua is related to water, aquarium. Audio, simple one. So audiophile, auditory, audio meter. Auto is another simple prefix that we can add. Automatic, automation. Bi, binary, bisexual, bivalve, etc. Bible. Bible actually means book. You might have heard bibliography, the list of books. Bibliophile is a person who is very much interested in reading books, who loves books. Then you have circum. Circum means around, circumference, circumnavigate. Then you have demos, relating to people, democracy, demographic. Then we have already discussed dis, opposite words. Ego, egocentric. Ego means related to yourself, I or self. Then ex means out, ex-husband, ex-minister. Then you have this common word geo, earth, that is geology, geography, etc. Graph, we have already, so hetero means mixed, we have already discussed. Homo is same. Then you have im and in, which means not, impossible, incredible. Inter is another prefix, which means between, interact. Lexis is word, lexicography. In that, lexi is the prefix. Locus means place. It is from locus that locality is formed. Micro, very small, microbiology, microscope. Mono means one, monogamy, monopoly. Then let us move on to philo. Philo means love, philosophy, philanthropy. Polis means city, political, metropolitan. Then you have these post, pre, pro words. Psyche is related to mind or soul. From psyche we got the word psychology. Then you have scope. Scope means examine, microscope. It's an example. In that, scope is a suffix. Then you have syn. Syn here means together, synchronize. Sympathy, syncretic, etc. Tele shows distance. Examples are telegraph, telephone, teleology, etc. Okay, you can write down these prefixes, meaning and examples. We will move on to suffixes. And so on the left hand side I have given the suffix and you have the meaning and also examples given. So first one is able or ible. Examples are agreeable, visible, etc. We'll move on to the third one, that is age. Age means state of or act of, storage, damage, etc. Then you have this ance, attendance, assistance. ARY, CIAN, magician, physician. CY, normalcy, prophecy. So all these are suffixes. And we tend to confuse the spelling of suffixes also. We have ANCE as well as ENCE. So we need to learn when to use ANCE and when to use ENCE. For attendance, we use ANCE, but for difference, we use ENCE. Then you have ESCENT, adolescent. Okay, so you have the scent as suffix there. You can write down all these things. Full, careful, helpful. HOOD, hood means order, manhood, adulthood. It is a condition also. IC, ICE, ID, ILE, INE. There are a lot of small suffixes which you have to be very careful about. LOG is a common suffix that you use by biology, physiology, anthropology. Then NOMY is also another suffix that we commonly use. Astronomy, autonomy, economy. Then some. Some means like. Lonesome, gruesome, etc. We add just the letter Y also, which means cheery, crafty, faulty. So in today's class, we have discussed different kinds of affixes. In affixes, we have discussed both prefixes and suffixes as well. And after giving different exercises, I have also touched upon Greek and Latin affixes and prefixes and suffixes. So here I have given certain references. You can visit these websites and check for more examples. So that is all for today. Thank you, students. Thank you for listening. Stay safe.